Let's go back upstairs to James Brown as we continue to prepare for what may or may not be the fight of the decade in the heavyweight division.
Preparation indeed, Jim and Bobby. Folks, we are all done with all of our undercard and pre-fight business. Indeed, the Lewis Tyson fight is next. The question is, and I think it might be appropriate, is are you surprised? Because after all these months of is it going to happen, where is it going to happen, and will it happen, the time has finally come to forget about all of those questions and focus on a boxing match.
Best there is.
I want your heart, I want even children. Praise be to Allah.
The fight is on. It is on for Mike Tyson. 16 years ago, Mike Tyson became the youngest heavyweight champion ever. He was destined to be one of the greatest of his era. But a fight with the Buster stopped the historic path once laid before him.
What an uppercut by Douglas, and down goes Tyson.
It's over.
Mike Tyson has been knocked out.
Since then, his early career accolades have turned into late career fiascos. Tonight, Tyson will try to redefine his prize-fighting status. Can this be the night of his boxing redemption? The fight is on. For Lennox Lewis, the champion who has proven his ability in the ring. But Lewis himself has also seen his path to the top take a turn for the worse. Most recently, between a rock and a mat place. However, he always answered his critics by avenging his losses.
It's over! Lennox got revenge!
The question of his greatness has always come down to his opponents. And tonight, Lennox Lewis faces what he considers the last man standing in his era.
Mike Tyson, you could say this is the last misfit in my era.
Can Lewis finally gain the respect that he truly deserves as the heavyweight champion of the world? Can he once and for all silence his detractors by defeating another notable opponent? Tonight, it is on.
Lennox, I'm coming for you.
You want it? Come and get it.
No more talking. No more waiting. Lewis versus Tyson.
The fight is on. Heavyweight champion Lennox Lewis against former champion Mike Tyson. Moments from now, both fighters will be entering the ring. Then you'll find out once and for all whether Lennox Lewis can take the punch and physically dominate Mike Tyson, or whether Tyson can regain the form and self-control which once made him the most feared champion in the sport. Lewis versus Tyson is being brought to you by The Pyramid Memphis. Brewery Fresh Budweiser, the undisputed, undefeated king of beers, this Bud's for you. And by America Online, so easy to use, no wonder it's number one. And during tonight's show, at keyword Lewis Tyson is on, America Online members will be able to get information, predict who will win tonight's main event, and vote during the fight on who you think is winning. So log on now to cast your vote for Lennox Lewis or Mike Tyson. We are now minutes away from one of the great spectacles in sport, the entrances of fighters in a heavyweight championship bout. The walkouts of Lennox Lewis and Mike Tyson will have special intrigue because this fight has been so anticipated. Plus, you can never forget the unpredictability of Mike Tyson. The crowd is indeed pumped up to see what could be a display of tremendous punching power. Among the notables who are here to watch this boxing match, again, celebrities from everywhere. Oscar winner Denzel Washington, Tommy Hearns, powerful himself in his day, Gregory Hines, and a guy who's enjoying join a skyrocketing career, The Rock. Chris Webber from the Sacramento Kings came so close to knocking off the Lakers along there with Tyra Banks. Roy Jones Jr. still with lightning quick hands. Vince McMahon, I guess you can call him an athlete as well. Donald Trump, the ever-present Donald Trump. And to the right there, Wesley Snipes, the actor, as well as Kevin Bacon to his left, and the guy who always follows boxing, Magic Johnson. And good evening once again, everyone. I'm James Brown. A pleasure to have you alongside as we get set for this main event here. I am pleased to be joined by the former heavyweight champion, Evander Holyfield, as we are just, again, as I said, moments away from the fight that has been the subject of much debate, and certainly the efforts to bring it to fruition have been fraught with controversy. Evander, let's get right to it. You have fought both Tyson and Lewis. You beat Tyson twice. It was a draw and a loss to Lennox Lewis, yet you're decidedly picking Mike Tyson. Why?
Well, styles make fight. I truly believe that Tyson's style offset Lennox Lewis' style. Lennox Lewis is a skillful boxer, but he's very unpredictable. He's very passionate. He don't have the passion or the fire that to dictate the pace.
Even if a guy is coming at him aggressively like we expect Tyson to, you wouldn't expect Lennox Lewis to be passive then, would you?
Well, you wouldn't expect him to see, but Tyson throw a lot of punches. It's not going to be just one punch. I'm sure that Tyson going to throw a lot of combination. And styles do make fights. When you go to the body and the head, the man that retrieving back tend to get hit with two or three other punches that one may throw.
Okay, let's make no mistake about it. Lennox Lewis is a champion, a guy who has a very powerful jab. So what will be Tyson's most effective weapon against Lennox Lewis?
Well, actually, it's his bobbing and weaving. His bobbing and weaving, jumping in there off key. Tyson's kind of orthodox when he moved back and forth. He's not on a really count. And then once he come into, he explodes into you. He bend down and he jump out just like a cobra. When you look at it, he's on top of you. He throwing the two or three shots in, and this is how he usually get one of the shots in.
As if I haven't heard you, and I did. I mean, with all due respect, you beat Tyson twice, as I mentioned before. You weren't able to get through and penetrate against Lennox Lewis. So what is it that Tyson will bring to the table that you weren't able to against Lennox Lewis?
Well, Tyson got a lot of springs in the leg. He got quicker steps. Tyson, he'll leap off that. I don't jump off the mat. Tyson will. Tyson take more chances than I take, and he may throw the right hand. He may throw the left hook. And if he can't reach, he'll jump up in the air and catch you. So, you know, he's unpredictable. And so a man that takes chances is always going to connect on one eventually.
You looked awfully sharp last week against Haseem Rahman. We know you have a lot at stake tonight, so we'll be watching with interest as well as you. Evander, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, partner. Folks, here are the results of who you at home think will win tonight's Lennox Lewis Mike Tyson fight. As you take a look, it is interesting. As we've gotten closer to fight time, more people have swung in Tyson's corner. As you heard Evander Holyfield said, 54% favor Mike Tyson will take the title from Lennox Lewis. And remember to vote round by round on who you think is actually winning the fight. We'll give you results throughout the night's fight. And now downstairs, once again, to the guys who will be calling the action, Jim Lampley and Bobby Chez.
All right, thank you very much, JB. Well, Bobby, you need not be a Harvard graduate to know that Mike Tyson is going to come to the center of the ring and attack. Emmanuel Stewart and everybody else in Lennox Lewis' camp says that Lewis is going to go straight at him and try to preempt Mike's aggression with his own aggression. That means this could be a brief, blazing combustion. Is that the fight you expect to see?
How could you not, after hearing that from both people? Mike Tyson fights in one direction, forward and one speed, very fast. If Lennox Lewis does what Emmanuel Stewart said, comes out looking to get his pound of flesh, looking to get his respect and put some hurt on Tyson, they have to meet in the middle of the ring and there has to be an explosion. I think early, the first 2 minutes of the first round, maybe even the first two or three rounds, this fight has to be explosive. If someone's still standing after that, it may level off. I just don't think so.
Good seats still available, but it's getting late. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape now for Lennox Lewis and Mike Tyson. Both of them getting up in years. Lewis will be 37 later this year. Tyson will be 36 at midsummer. 6-inch height advantage on paper for Lewis. Some suspect it's even bigger than that. 13-inch reach advantage for Lewis. An advantage when he's outside. But can Mike get inside of that big reach advantage? And the unofficial weights, I say unofficial, well, let's call them the official weights, because this was done on the Tennessee scale. 249 and a quarter for Lewis, 234 and a half for Tyson. Both camps agree, as we've told you, that the scale was off 6 or 7 pounds heavy. They say Lewis weighs in the range of 243. Tyson, 234, not that, but rather about 227 or 228. Rules of the bout with Bobby Chez.
Thank you, Jim. This fight, we use the rules of the Association of the Boxing Commissions. Scoring is a 10-point must system with no standing eight and no three knockdown rule. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. Only the referee can stop the fight. And in case of an accidental foul, we go to the scorecard after round number four.
As the challenger for the crown, Mike Tyson will walk out first. And here comes Iron Mike.
You think it's a fucking game? Come on! Come on! What y'all gonna do? What y'all gonna do? Come on, guys! Oh, yeah! Hey, yo! Bust my thing! DMX and I'll be the best. You see the rest of it.
Crazy ballers out of town.
time in Miami Beach than anywhere else. But then a lot of Europeans are in that camp.
The International Boxing Federation, the International Boxing Organization, and the great state of Tennessee.
Representing the WBC, President Jose Suleiman, Supervisors General Kovet Paktipum and Rex Ross Walker. For the IBF, President Marion Mohammed, Supervisor Linda Torres. The IBO President and Supervisor Ed Levine, and the Tennessee Commerce and Insurance Commissioner is Ann Pope.
The three judges assigned to ringside scoring this contest on the 10 points must system are: from South Africa, Alfred Bukwana; from Thailand, Anik Hong Tong Kam; and from Belgium, Bob Logis. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action from the United States, Eddie Cotton.
All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, the time for talk is over. The time to fight is here. It's the time we've all been waiting for. Live from the Pyramid in Memphis, it's fight time! Introducing to you first the challenger on my right. He is fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring wearing his traditional solid black trunks and hailing from Catskill, New York. He weighed in at 234.5 pounds with a record of 49 wins, 3 losses, 2 no contests. He has 43 big wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the youngest man ever to win the heavyweight title, currently ranked the number one contender by the WBC. Please welcome tonight's challenger, the explosive 2-time heavyweight champion of the world, introducing the one and only Iron Mike Tyson.
And hiding out of the red corner, wearing white, trimmed with red letters, and officially weighing 249.25 pounds. He captured Olympic gold in 1988. Now, as a professional, he has 39 victories, including 30 knockouts and 3 world titles. He has 2 defeats and a draw. All by way of rematch have been changed to victories, making him one of the few men in boxing history to have virtually defeated every man he has ever faced. Ladies and gentlemen, from London, England, presenting the 3-time world champion, the linear, legitimate, and universally recognized, undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Lenny Destiny's hero. Only one will pass from heavyweight greatness to heavyweight legend. So now there's only one thing left to say. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
With 16-year-old Mike Tyson. They lived in the same room for a week, sparred every day.
aggressively.
All right, stop her, stop her, stop her. Come on, stop her.
Tyson trying to get to Lewis's body with the left hook. Lewis wrapping Tyson up when he gets inside. No expert expected Lewis to try to fight inside with Tyson.
Right now, Lewis isn't trying to fight at all. He's just trying to sort of thwart the punches by stepping into him and smothering him and then hold on.
Jab by Lewis. Tyson rocks him with a left hook. Lewis doing a lot of holding in the first minute and 40. Lewis's right hand shot. Mike not jabbing his way in though, Bobby, just walking in.
Well, he's trying to jab his win, but he's trying to get the right hand to land somewhere too. To hurt Lennox so he can get the left hand combination following.
Big left hand by Tyson after the jab by Lewis.
And he worked that hook off a jab.
This time it's Tyson who grabs Lewis as Lennox was about to fire the uppercut.
Lennox is looking to try and time Mike with that right hand. There you saw it. But Lennox is backing up a little too much.
Big right hand over the top by Lewis. Grabs Tyson as Mike falls inside.
Lennox is laying on the back of Mike's neck quite a bit. He'll be telling on Mike's back later in the fight.
One punch at a time, neither fighter has put together a coherent combination in the first round.
This man ain't much on a fighter. Just settle down. If you really would see how bad he looks, you would be surprised. Settle down, get yourself together, start working your jab. You took all of the anger and slowed him down already by wrestling and tying him up. Okay? Just take your time. Don't let him fight the fight that he's trying to make you fight. Take your time, get to work with your jab. If you hit him with the right hands and uppercut, just slow down.
Maybe two. If you can get two in, that's fine, okay? But don't let this guy try to tie you out. Relax yourself. I'm telling him.
Just stay cool.
We hollering at him, okay? Okay, just relax yourself, baby. That was a good round.
Double
you won
jab.
The first round, okay?
Double jab like we worked on. Step up and control the second jab. You got
every
this guy.
Time to get one. I love. Start using your face now. He's trying to load over with his right hands on that. He can try to come on top first and then uppercut, okay? Be fast, baby. Be fast.
Tyson, concerned between rounds about Lewis holding him and putting his weight on him, asked Ronnie Shields to talk to referee Eddie Cotton. Shields just turned around and made that comment to Cotton, who ignored him and said, come back and fight.
Well, the first round, Mike was technically the effective aggressor because Lewis wasn't really aggressive. He threw more punches. He landed a few more. Got to give him the first round, but not by a lot.
And now the crowd approves as Cotton warns Lewis for holding. The first warning.
Nice and easy, come on.
Uppercut, half blocked.
Yeah, the uppercut landed on the elbow of Mike coming in. He's got his hands tight. Even there, not really hitting a lot on the way in. It seems that Lennox is more concerned with finding which arm to grab first rather than get his punches in.
Jab by Lewis, he hasn't really gotten it going. Now he starts to work in rhythm. Tyson lunging, firing with the left hook. Lewis was gone.
Pick it up. Nice and easy. Come on, pick it up.
Tyson fighting at a measured pace, not the whirlwind that some expect. Lewis seems to believe that the uppercut is going to be a big weapon for him here.
It has to be. Big man gets leverage with the uppercut. Mike's coming in. He's ducking down under the punches. He'll walk right into it. But there, Mike, even with the double jab, and he's short, he needs to throw the right hand. As Lennox dips with that. step to it. When he can't worry if the jab lands. He's just got to get him to the inside where he's got to fire to right, to the body, to the jaw, and follow with the left.
At that time, as they joined together, Lewis held his arms in the air as if to say, I'm not the one who's holding. And uppercut and a left hook from Lewis. He doesn't throw it all that often.
Threw a nice right hand, uppercut and a left hook. It was beautiful. Mike put it on the chin very well. This round's all Lennox Lewis.
All Lennox Lewis in round two, and increasingly so as the round progressed.
Okay, look, champion, look, listen to me. Remember I told you, you cannot let this man throw too many jabs at you without you coming back with something, right? Okay, look, you started using your face, but you quit jabbing. You have to be in this man's chest, you understand? Make this a very ugly fight now, okay? I want you right
in. He's slowing down real bad.
35?
It's 35
everyone.
Left hand.
Keep your hands
work
up.
Work your jab. Jab is pumping now. Your jab is pumping. That's what you're waiting for, right there.
Keep your hands up, baby. Keep
fighting
right
the masterpiece
up.
That round. You're on your way.
Mouthpiece. Here you go. Here
you're
go.
On your way, baby.
Seconds out!
Round three begins. After seeming to control the tempo in round one, Mike Tyson slowed considerably in round two. Lennox Lewis got his jab working. You heard Emmanuel Stewart say, just keep it up.
Lennox Lewis made the adjustments in the second round. Now Mike needs to remake adjustments on his side.
Lewis not holding, but rather just pushing Tyson off.
Right, Mike's got to come back in behind the jab and fire. He can't just try and hit him with the jab. The jab is not meant to just be a point getter for Mike. It's meant to close the distance and put something in Lennox's
punch
face
out,
to worry
out,
about.
Punch out, punch out, punch out, get out, get out, get out.
And you heard Ronnie Shields say, get into his chest and make it an ugly fight. The more they fight from this range, the more Lewis's chances increase.
All right, stop him, stop. Step back.
Mike can't win the fight at that distance. If Lennox Lewis can set the distance of this fight, Mike has no chance. He has to shut the gap down, get inside, bring the fight to where he's comfortable.
Does he look eager enough to do it?
Mike looks like he's waiting too much. Doesn't look like he's found his rhythm. Lennox Lewis's jab is finding his mark more and more often.
Lewis picking Mike Tyson off with the jab as Mike tries to step in, able to keep Tyson at long range so far in round three.
Get out. Come on.
Lewis no longer seems to be trying to hit Tyson with anything big, Bobby. He's just tapping it.
Well, the jab is a pretty stiff jab, not a real shotgun jab, but it's a pretty stiff jab. Popping Mike's head up, and then when he comes in, Mike, he just ties him up.
Stop that.
You can almost see Lewis trying to fight his natural tendency to go backward. His mind wants to go forward, his body wants to lean back.
And I sometimes think his body wants to go forward, his mind keeps pulling his body back because he's worried about getting hit with those shots.
There is blood around the right eye of Mike Tyson. Tyson blinking a little bit and looking momentarily distracted by what seems to be a nick somewhere near his right eye. That would be the product of Lewis's jab. And there's a huge left hook by Tyson, but Lewis took it well.
Lewis took it well. Didn't seem to be anything there.
Stop punch.
That was Mike's best punch of the fight. But the Lewis chin held up. And now Tyson begins to paw at the blood on his right eye, and Lewis busts him with a right hand. Look at Lewis dropping his hands to his waist.
Let's go.
Well, you know what?
Come on, let's go.
More than one man has gotten cocky and lost because of it. Not the time or the man to do it against.
That's where Lewis was holding his hands when Haseem Rahman knocked him out in South Africa.
I rest my case.
Superior choice to what was the case in Tokyo against James Buster Douglas,
Tyson,
where Tyson's eyes swelled while his corner fiddled.
Okay, Mike, you're fine, Mike.
You gotta relax
yourself.
Give
me a towel to wipe him.
Give me a towel.
Real relax.
Okay, nice and relaxed. Now, Mike, look, listen to me. Now, look, you let this guy have his way on the outside. You understand? Don't let this man have his way on the outside. You got to be close to this man. You understand? You got to stay close. And when you get close, shoot your uppercuts and go to the body with this man. Okay? Use your feet.
He can't deal with nothing right coming now. To him. Yeah, this fight's from dealing with if you do. You sit down and get yourself together.
Drink.
You can't just be retentive to do this here and do this. Shoot that damn uppercut some. The man is tired.
Watch Lennox Lewis use that jab real effective. Popping Mike right on the eye. Popping Mike right off the side of the head. That jab very effective in that round and the round previous probably is what opened that cut.
So as round four begins, Lennox Lewis has gotten the fight to go in the direction he wanted it to go. But Emmanuel Stewart still didn't seem happy between rounds. And Tyson again lands a left hook, but again Lewis is unfazed. Jab, jab, jab. Uppercut. That's been the Lewis battle.
Lewis is fighting a smart fight, jabbing in time, Mike up on the inside, jab on the wing, get the points. Him with the right hand.
Right hand. Right cross landed flush for Lewis. But Tyson took it well. He's got a good chin, Bobby.
Mike's got a good chin. He's pretty tough. You're not going to stop him in one shot. I don't think so. I really don't.
Another solid right cross, though. You can't take too many of those.
You sure can't knock a man who weighs 250 pounds.
Tyson misses the left hook. Lewis counters effectively with the right. Big round for Lewis so far. Body shot by Lennox Lewis.
I think right now Mike Tyson's a little bit dazed. I think he's extremely confused.
He's not blocking Lewis's right hand, Bobby. Now some head movement. Tyson's confidence ebbing. Lewis is seeming to grow.
Mike seems to be loading up just a little too much, Jim. He's taking a fraction of the speed off his punches, giving Lennox enough time to cover up. Came in with a jab and didn't do anything behind it. No hook, no right hand, no body work.
One punch at a time by Tyson. Another right hand lands flush and an uppercut as Lewis, just as he did with Michael Grant, effectively held Tyson's head in position with his left hand and hit him with the right.
And that is illegal. I'm surprised the referee didn't say anything. You can't do that, but it's done and over with.
If we can see it, we know Eddie Cotton can see it. Jab, jab. Tyson trying to duck inside, but not able to creatively attack.
Mike's not throwing enough punches. He wouldn't be able to tie his hands up if they were moving.
Another right hand flush. That one missed. Tyson lunging with the left hook. Lewis blocked it. Lands another right hand.
There were two right hands. They both were just barely missed the mark. They glanced off each other's shoulders. That would have been explosive.
Bobby, is Mike becoming increasingly vulnerable to these right hands because of the cut on his eye?
I don't think it's a cut on his eye. I think he's confused. I think he's not making the adjustments. Mentally, it's not clicking in what he needs to do.
And more, down goes Tyson. It's not going to be ruled a knockdown because Eddie Cotton is going to say that Lewis was holding him while he hit him. Lawrence Cole, what's the ruling here?
He got pushed down, so that would not be a knockdown. He leaned on his back after that punch was gone, and then he pushed him down. Oh, they're deducting a point.
And now Eddie Cotton is going to deduct a point.
He hit him in the back.
Lewis,
the point was for hitting him in the back, I believe. Did he hit Mike? He helped push Mike down, and then he hit him in the back.
So Lewis loses a point.
Don't turn it by him. Come on. Get this motherfucker out of your man.
Listen to Emmanuel.
He's ready to get caught with some crazy shit. Step it up, the man is finished.
Put them shits together, baby.
You
put them together.
You ain't never took it to himself. Get your hands.
You cannot just run in. The right hand is down. When he jabbed, throw the right hand and no hook behind it. Okay? Just give me a deep breath, champ.
Fine.
Okay? You can give me another round like that.
Watch Lennox Lewis on the way in. Mike bends. Now he's on the top of him, and he punches him in the back as he pushed him down a little bit. The weight of a 250-pound man, a little tough. Here you see him. Look, jump on the back of his neck, push him down, and hit him in the back. That's a foul. Technically, that's a clean foul. I mean, that punch was nowhere near hitting legal territory.
But in the round, Lennox Lewis landed a series of right-hand shots, and Mike Tyson did all but nothing.
Mike Tyson right now is having problems adjusting. This round is going to be indicative of how this fight could turn out. Mike Tyson can come back in this round.
Tyson tries to counter Lewis's jab with a right hand. Misses wildly. Lewis on target with another combination. Bobby, how do you have it scored so far?
Well, I had first round for Mike. The next
Tyson hurt. Lewis seems to be waiting for one big shot now.
You know what? That's not a smart thing to do. I think he should just work the way he's been working. Work behind the jab like that.
He can win the fight easily just by sticking the jab, or so it would appear. Tyson hasn't looked dangerous for the last couple of rounds. Lewis moving. Tyson finally steps in and fires a body shot.
Mike is no work output right now. He's got to throw punches. He's being outworked and he's being played with. He's being played, being target practice. Not good for Mike Tyson.
Lewis able to load up on the uppercut and still landing.
He's able to do whatever he wants. Mike's not posing a threat to him at any part of the combination execution.
It is rapidly becoming what some boxing experts predicted might be the case: a technical mismatch between a veteran fighter who's been in the ring the whole time against top opposition and has a lot of craft, and another guy who may well have squandered too much of his ability.
And you still doing this? Just let that shit go. This fight is over with. You gonna fuck around and let him catch you with some shit if you don't watch. This man is dead out there, but he wants to quit. And you out here playing.
No. Give me all you got one round. Just let me go hands. I just want your hands moving this round. Can you stay close to this man?
Fine.
And get your hands moving this round for me.
Mike, you go out. You're fine.
No, I need your hands moving. You got too much distance. You let this guy jab the hell out of you. You got to move your hands. Now, we got to win this.
Doing this. The man has said that let this shit go. Right hand over top, right hand uppercut.
Stay alert, Lance.
Any longer this fight going, this man is dangerous. You better get him out of here.
Right now. Exactly.
Goddamn right. Now, this is ridiculous.
Stay alert. Hands up.
Lennox Lewis unloading at will. Here's a right uppercut that looks like opened the cut over the left eye of Mike Tyson. Turned it up nice and inside and followed with a little short inside right hook.
If Tyson's trainer, Ronnie Shields, seems disappointed and bewildered by his fighter's performance, Emmanuel Stewart is incensed, screaming at Lennox Lewis, "You got a dead man in front of you. Quit screwing around."
Well, what Emmanuel Stewart says is right to the degree. Not that he's a dead man, but when he has Mike on the ropes, close him out. Don't give him a chance to get back in the fight. He's dangerous at all times.
Now Lewis begins to expend more energy and again fires a right hand down the pipe.
Mike's just not punching. Mike's confused. The jab's in his face. Right hand's behind it. Lennox doing what he wants at his leisure.
How many right crosses can Mike Tyson take? That was big. Boy, Tyson's got a good chin.
Okay. He's hit Mike Lee with some big punches, and he's a good puncher, Lennox Lewis. Mike's showing a rock chin.
When he hit David Tua with two of those shots in the first round, Tua didn't want much part of him from that point forward. Crunch with the body shot by Tyson. One punch at a time, though, won't get it done.
It absolutely won't. One and done. He's never going to win this fight.
Lewis misses with that right hand. Begins to paw again with the jab. And Emmanuel Stewart gets another stricken look on his face in the Lewis corner.
Lennox Lewis is content right now to just stay outside, stick the jab, and not really try and put a hurting on Mike. And Emmanuel Stewart wants him to finish this.
Target practice. Handy from a baby. This is easy for Lewis. If he doesn't get caught with something big, he's going to walk to victory.
And Mike's going back. He's not affected whatsoever.
Easy, nice and easy. Come on, step back.
But remember, Tyson remains dangerous. He lost all of the first four rounds to Franz Botha on all three cards, and then knocked him out with a big shot in the fifth. However, Lewis is no Franz Botha.
Now, Lewis does not have the chin of Botha, but he's also a much better fighter, much better defensive fighter, much better offensive fighter, 10 times more dangerous, and right now, commanding the show.
There's a little mouse under the left eye of Lewis, so Tyson has done some damage with the right hand.
He landed one good right hand, a left uppercut, and a right hand over the top a little bit ago, but again, one and two, one and done, not enough.
And you wonder how long Mike will be able to see effectively out of two eyes that are swelling rapidly. going to quit.
Keep throwing them damn uppercuts at him. He can't get away from him. Keep shooting uppercuts.
What is this coming up?
7-8.
There's no way to where this man should be in here this long. And the longer he's in here, the dangerous it is. You keep working the jab, but you got to add to it. You every time you get you hesitate, you start to throw the shot, then you hesitate. Let the stop go. The man ain't that dangerous. Finish the shot, go in.
And come back with your right hand. You understand? Let your hands go. That's all we're telling you to do right now. Everybody can't talk in the corner.
You can do it.
One at a fucking time.
You can do it.
Listen.
Mike, don't worry about it.
Be fast. You understand me? Fast.
Lennox loose, standing there, doing what he wants. There's a left and a right hand. Mike offering up almost nothing in return. Same replay, slow-mo. Left hand, right to the temple. And then he just gets out of the way because Mike doesn't counter fast enough and doesn't really counter enough.
Well, if ever Mike Tyson needed one lightning shot, now's the time. Lennox Mike. Lewis seemingly building a lead on the scorecards, although with a point deducted for holding and hitting. Bobby, how do you have it through six?
Well, right now, after six, I have it 4-1 and one even, because the one even round was the point taken. Lennox was clearly winning the round, but he fouled Mike. Right now, 58-55, it's a three-point edge. Mike Tyson is quickly approaching the point of no return.
Another good right-hand shot for Lewis. Tyson not doing much of anything. Jab for Lewis. Tyson at range where he can't find it. Another big right hand. Target practice.
Pushed off with a forearm, which is technically illegal. It's not called an awful lot, but nonetheless illegal.
Biggest upset of the night.
Every warning
by Cotton so far goes to Lennox Lewis. Mike Tyson hadn't been close to committing a foul.
He really hasn't. He's a little too docile tonight all the way around. Now I see no meanness in his eyes.
Now blood trickling from the nose of Tyson, as well as both eyes. Huge right hand by Lewis.
That was mostly blocked by Mike, but he's not offering up anything back. He threw a small left hook to the body. Nothing there. Mike Tyson is being dictated to by the all-important Lennox Lewis jab and a good right hand with pinpoint accuracy tonight.
Mike Tyson is being dictated to by craft, technique, professional skill. That's what Lewis has in addition to his size.
He certainly demonstrated some of the very best of it tonight.
Huge right hands. They're missing. They're glancing blows. But Tyson's doing nothing in return. And the blood and the swelling increasingly distracting to Mike.
Punches to make Lennox worry about anything. Lennox doing what he wants.
Occasionally, Lewis has felt a significant punch from Tyson, thus the swelling under the left eye. But basically, Mike has thrown one punch at a time, and most of them ineffective. Lewis is the only man in the fight who's landed a combination. There's a three-punch combination. There's another right cross. Mike just ducking, not firing.
Mike almost appears to be resolved that he's not going to win this fight. Let me just stand here and take it. Take one swing here and there, but it doesn't look like he's trying to win. You have to put yourself in a position to win by fighting. He's not fighting.
Ronnie Shields was trying to say to Tyson in a subtle way that he'll consider throwing in the towel if this gets worse. What a letdown it would be to the Tyson public to see Iron Mike throw in the towel.
There's a beautiful right hand to the body, but he should have came up top with the left hook.
Tyson trying to let his hands go, catches two huge uppercuts. Why did Eddie Cotton pull him off?
And I called it a knockdown. I think Mike Lee might have grazed the canvas. I'm
six,
not sure.
Seven. Eight. You all right, Mike? Come on, you have to go, Mike.
So it's being counted as a knockdown because there's no standing eight count in effect. Tyson's glove must have been seen to touch the canvas. First knockdown of the fight. Now Lewis goes for the knockout. Hurts Tyson with the right hand. Tyson grabbing and holding on.
Almost half the round is left. I don't know if Mike has enough to keep Lennox off.
Lopsided fight, getting more so. Big shots from Lewis. Of Tokyo and the one time he got the Buster Douglas at the end of the eighth round. And that's going to be perhaps the end of the fight. It'll take some courage for Mike to get up from that shot.
7, 8, 9.
He's out. Lennox Lewis knocks out Mike Tyson and banishes him from the upper stratosphere of the heavyweight division right now.
The worst performance of Mike's life.
Way too good.
Last man standing.
Give me some water. Here, Mike, take some water, Mike.
So even though Emmanuel Stewart thought it should have gone quicker, Lennox Lewis gets the last laugh. His wisdom plays out. He played it coolly in the ring, and he waited until Mike was most vulnerable and took him out.
Lennox didn't take any stupid chances. It's a smart move with smart boxing. He dominated Mike from start to finish. Mike never got on track, and Lennox didn't let him get a chance to get in the game.
Did you call that one of the better Lewis's performances you've seen?
That may be the best performance I've seen Lewis to date.
And it answers the question of who's the best heavyweight for now, doesn't it?
Does for me.
Here's the knockout, Bobby.
You watch the right uppercut. He hurts Mike with it, and he hits him with a beautiful left uppercut following. Mike there, I wasn't sure if the right knee touched. I thought it didn't, but evidently Eddie Cotton thought it did. But watch his left uppercut lift up right on Mike's jaw. You see him, his legs buckle, and I still can't. His knee did not hit the canvas. He does not go down.
Moot point.
He does not go down. There's no standing eight count. Eddie Cotton made a mistake.
If he didn't go down, then in effect the knockdown count was a benefit to Tyson because it gave him a chance to recover.
And here's the end. Mike is caught another right hand, and this is it. He is done. That one a la Haseem Rahman too.
Well, it took Buster Douglas 10 rounds to knock out Mike Tyson. It took Evander Holyfield 9+. Lennox Lewis gets it done in the eighth.
7+.
7+. And the Lewis right hand now ranks as the dominant weapon in the heavyweight division, as he showed tonight.
That he did, and he has just done a lot to seal his legacy in the Hall of Fame for the future.
Walking past us right now, a very happy Violet Lewis, Lennox's mother, who's been with him all the way through his championship run. Lennox Lewis, world junior champion, Olympic gold medalist, three-time heavyweight champion, knockout conqueror of Mike Tyson. What else could he prove, Bobby?
Right now, there's not much he can prove. I'm sure he wants to be undisputed one more time. I'm not sure the winner of Ruiz or Kirk Johnson will face him, but I bet you that's what comes out of his mouth in the interview.
He'd be a heavy favorite over either. Here are the official particulars.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight here in Memphis, Tennessee, the legacy of a three-time heavyweight champion has been embraced as the referee reaches the count of 10. At 2 minutes, 25 seconds of round number 8, the winner by knockout victory and still the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, the pride of Great Britain, Lennox
much. Lennox, Mike, if you can come on over here.
One more
gentlemen.
Replay look at the crunching right hand, which ended the evening for Mike Tyson and gave Lennox Lewis the biggest, gaudiest, showiest victory of his career. There were those who thought that Lewis didn't prove enough with his decision against Holyfield. Let's see what they think now. Let's go into the ring where Jim Gray is standing by with Lennox Lewis.
All right. Thank you very much, Jim. Lennox, congratulations to you. You dominated this fight. Was that what you had anticipated?
Yeah, basically, you know, I just wanted to stay to the game plan, use my jab. I kind of, the first round was a bit rough for me because I never settled down. Manny told me to settle down a bit more. And actually, Manny told me to take him out like the fourth round, but still, you know, I just wanted to soften him up a bit more with my jab, but he was still determined, he was still tough, and he can take a hell of a punch because I hit him with some great punches, and boy, he can take him, for real.
We have Mike Tyson here as well. Mike, have you changed your opinion now of Lennox Lewis?
Well, no. Believe it or not, I've known Lennox for like 15, 16 years. We've always been friends, but in competition, in competition, the best man has to win. We have to do everything we can. I'm happy for him to give me a fight. The payday was wonderful. I really appreciate it. And if you could be kind enough, I'd love to do it again. I think I could beat you if we try one more time.
Mike, what gives you any indication that you could beat him after this performance? And was it a lack of quality opponents going into this that hurt you?
I explained before I needed two more fights or three more fights to fight him. But I believe if I would have took that route, the fight probably would have never happened. He wouldn't have waited for me. And again, he was just splendid, a masterful boxer. I just take my hand off to you. And just please, if you can just do, give me one more chance, I'd be greatly appreciative.
Are you interested in that at all, based on the way you controlled this fight?
You know, I just wanted to complete my legacy. You know, everybody was saying that, you know, this fight is going to count on my legacy. So I just wanted to prove to the people that, you know, I'm the best fighter in the world, on the planet. No guy tests this man.
I'll prove that right now. You were quite annoyed. You had some very derogatory things to say about Mike coming into this fight. You said you had to win this fight to clean up boxing. Do you feel you've accomplished that?
Well, I showed boxing, you know, who's the best in the world. I went out there and showed him I'm a pugilist specialist. I can adapt to any style. And, you know, he showed me one style that a lot of people didn't think I was going to be able to deal with. But I was able to deal with it. A lot of people thought he was going to get away from my jab, but nobody gets away from my jab.
Mike, you behaved tonight. Everybody.
One of his biggest fans, brother.
Manny Stewart, say that again.
I was telling Mike, I'm still one of his biggest fans. He's given me so many thrills, man. You know, go back to Roderick Moore, you remember?
Yeah, my friend Roderick.
Yeah, I know. It was a long time back.
Mike,
you've given all of us a lot of excitement. Most
thank
exciting
you.
Heavyweight in the last 50 years.
Thank you very much. It was just beautiful. I'm just so happy you gave me a chance. Nobody wanted to give me a chance. Don King didn't want to give me a chance. I'm just happy someone gave me a chance.
I don't know how to do it, but you still can punch.
Thank you very much.
Champ and Mike, how sorry are you guys that this fight did not occur many years ago when you were at your best and probably you weren't quite as old either?
Well, you know, the funny thing about that is, you know, every weight's mature at different times. I would say Mike Tyson matured at 19. He was nothing was standing in his way at that time. He ruled the planet at that time. But I'm like fine wine. I come along later on, and, you know, I learned my art and went along and just took my time. And I came along and just ruled. I'm ruling now.
Mike, are you sorry this fight didn't take place years ago?
It wasn't meant to be. I've known Little Terry since he was 16, 15 years old. I have mad respect. Everything I said was in proposition for promoting the fight. He knows I love him and his mother, and I know if he thinks I don't have respect and don't love him, he's crazy.
So you're saying a lot of the behavior, Mike, is certain just to sell tickets, and that doesn't represent your true feelings?
Well, he knows who I am, and he knows I'm not disrespectful. I respect this man as a brother. He knew me ever since his friend Bernie and Cuss were together, and he knows I have the much respect for him. Like I said before, he's a magnificent, a prolific fighter, and he should continue fighting. I would just love for him to give me another shot.
How important was it for you tonight, Mike, to come out here and be a sportsman and behave in the ring?
Oh, no, it was very I said I love and respect him too much to do anything disrespectful to him, and he knows that. And for him to think that is absolutely crazy.
Mike, we appreciate your time. You're most gracious in defeat tonight, and I think a lot of fans out there will appreciate the way that you've handled yourself tonight after some disappointing moments and some behavior in the past that hasn't been very well at all. Lennox, what now happens for you? Where do you go now? You've basically proven everything. You've beaten everybody. You've avenged the losses you've had, and you've conquered the man who you said would make your legacy. What now?
Well, you know, I'm gonna take one day at a time, see what happens after this. I just wanted to complete this goal. Everybody was asking me what I'm going to do after this fight. But, you know, I'm the best fighter in the world. I just wanted to prove that to the whole planet. And, you know, I'm going to take one day at a time.
When he bit you, what was your reaction back on January 22nd? And did you think this one was going out the window?
Shit, I was shocked, you know, because I'm saying we're two fighters. We're going to fight it out. Why not? Let's fight it out. But the man grabbed my leg and bit it. I was shocked. And then in some way, I thought he was trying to get out of the fight. But then I said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get him back in the fight, you know. Biting was first blood. I got second blood tonight.
Well, let's take a look at that second blood. We have a chance to look down at the monitor. If you'll jump forward here for us and tell us what happened on the knockout punch. He had already gone down with the standing eight count.
I was noticing he was ducking to his left, to my right, and I just wanted to catch him as he was doing that. And I caught him right on the chin, and he went down. But I'm telling you, some of those punches I caught him on the right side, he took like a man, and I was shocked that he was able to take him because I felt him right through my hand.
Were you surprised that he was only one punch and out tonight, that he put together no combinations?
No, you know, I'm thinking that Mike Tyson at his best. I'm in there not taking no chances, just waiting for my time, and just going about my sport as a pugilist specialist.
Would you give him a rematch? Is that a legitimate request after this?
Well, you know, he's asked for one. I definitely would consider it, you know, but it depends what the people want. You know, I'm going to take one day at a time. Emmanuel Stewart, the best trainer in the world. No guy tests this trainer.
Last question. Possible retirement? Might this have been the crowning achievement, and you'll say goodnight?
Yes, possible. Anything is possible. Big up our crew.
Lennox Lewis, congratulations to you. Terrific fight
crew,
tonight. Okay. All right, Jim Lampley, let's go back down to you.
Thank you, Jim. And Bobby, let's out our voices on one subject. Mike Tyson came in here, fought a clean, sportsmanlike fight, was utterly sportsmanlike in the ring afterward. What an amazing shot. Mike wiping the blood off of Lennox's cheek while Lennox answered one of Jim Gray's questions. Credit to Tyson for being a real man in there.
Credit to Tyson for being a real sportsman, being humbled. He, much like myself, is humbled by Lennox Lewis. Lennox knows that I picked Mike. Mike knows I picked Mike. You know I picked Mike. Lennox Lewis today was the epitome of the sweet science. And I've always said, hell hath no fury like a woman scorned and a fighter with something to prove. Lennox had something to prove, and he proved it tonight in blazing glory.
After this, given the fact that the contract allows for a rematch, either next or after one more fight for Lewis if he chooses, now that Lewis has the confidence of having done this, what chance is there that the rematch could be competitive?
I think the rematch might be a little more competitive because Mike wasn't expecting what he got. Now he might be able to make some of those adjustments that he and his corner weren't able to make in the first few rounds, which is what led him constantly getting punished and eventually knocked out.
But he's going to have to go back to throwing combinations. He's going to have to be much more disciplined in punching to the body. He's going to have to be a lot better.
I completely agree, and I think if he looks at that tape, just my simple call of working behind the jab, even if it doesn't land, will shut down that distance, put a hand in Lewis's face to worry about and deal with, go to the body, but then come immediately up. That's the only way he can win against big men. Only way.
Well, it was one thing for Lewis to avenge his defeat to Haseem Rahman by knocking Rahman out in November. It was spectacular, but a lot of people thought, well, of course, he was supposed to do that before in South Africa. But a lot of people didn't think that Lennox Lewis could attack and destroy against a machine like Mike Tyson. And now Lewis has answered all of those doubters as well. Another big right hand from Lewis, similar to the one that finished Rockman. And now Mike Tyson has a lot to think about as he goes off into the darkness of this latest bad night. As Tyson falls and the count reaches 10, let's go back upstairs to James Brown.
All right, Jim and Bobby Chaz, thank you guys so very much. We are blessed to be joined by one of the sharpest minds, if not the fastest hands in the business, Roy Jones Jr. Your insight, absolutely always on the mark. First of all, let me do it in reverse order. Were you surprised at the graciousness that Tyson displayed toward Lewis at the end?
No, man. I think Tyson deserved to come out and show the world that he's still a man. He, you know, a lot of things Tyson has been accused of, I don't really think that he meant any harm. It's just that Tyson has a legacy. He has a person. He has his character about him that he has to go out and display. He can't let you look at him as some wimp or some nice guy. That was never the Mike Tyson of boxing, so he cannot be that.
So even the crass, vulgar remarks that we heard throughout the promotion route by Tyson, he says aimed at promoting the fight.
I believe that. I dearly believe that because he knows what he was getting himself into. He really, like he said, he needed more time to prepare. That's why he wasn't throwing combinations and bunches tonight. He hasn't had a decent fight since 1997 when he fought Evander Holyfield. He has a lot of turmoil from that time to now. That's a lot of time to not have a competitive heavyweight fight.
As well as Jim Lampley underscored during the bout, you heard Tyson at least twice request another fight from Lennox Lewis. Financially driven or because he firmly believes that he can beat him?
Well, I think it's partially both. Financially driven because that's the biggest fight for him right now. He really feels like, I mean, a guy who didn't get a chance. He didn't get a fair opportunity to prepare for this. A lot of it, some of it probably his fault, some of it probably other reasons. But he didn't get the opportunity to really tune himself up and get ready for a Lennox Lewis fight. This is why I predicted if the fight went past three rounds, it was Lennox Lewis all day. Lennox has been fighting competitive fights. Tyson hasn't really had a chance to put together a string of competitive victories.
And I guess just to coattail on that, extrapolating it just a bit more, Tyson did say after the Brian Nielsen fight of the Danish pastry, if you will, that he did in fact need at least two more competitive fights before he could step up in quality. Now, if you're Lennox Lewis, you've done it all. What more is there to prove? Should he retire? Should he continue on?
Well, I mean, he doesn't really have anything left to prove. He pretty much silenced all the critics tonight. He did everything that he should have done. He fought a very smart fight. He started out a little dangerous because you don't go out and trade with Mike Tyson and you're 6'5". But he pulled himself together. It kind of wore both fighters down. And he was able to pick up his second win a lot quicker than Mike because he's been doing this over the last 5 or 6 years. Mike, like I said again, hasn't had a competitive fight since the Holyfield fight.
Final point. Terrific technician was Lewis in the ring tonight, and a masterful game plan by his trainer, Emmanuel Stewart.
Very masterful game plan. Use the jab, frustrate Mike, keep him on the ropes, keep him backing up, never let him get his balance, never let him put a string of two or three punches together. That is when he's most dangerous. But by knowing the fact, Emmanuel knowing that Mike has been off so long, he knows that Mike has rust and that the rust would show up late in the fight. So he wanted to get Lennox through the first few rounds, use the jab, be smart, be patient, and the knockout will come.
I think you noticed from me, it's good to see you again, dude.
Thank you so much. It's good to see everybody. All my fans, Roy Jones is coming. I offer Bernard Hopkins $6 million. If he don't take it, he's a punk and he won't fight me. It's simple as that. $6 million is 3 times more than he got to fight against Felix Trinidad. I'm telling you right now, $6 million is on the table. If you want Roy Jones, step up or shut up.
They must have forgot Roy can chat as well, too. Hey, folks, let me just say this real quickly. I'm certainly pleased to have seen the graciousness displayed by Mike Tyson. I consider him a better man for having done that as well. Lennox Lewis, while he may not have captured the public's fancy with his style, a superb champion, and you cannot deny the technical proficiency that he delivers consistently whenever he's in the ring. All right, folks, Lewis versus Tyson has been brought to you by the Pyramid Memphis. Brewery Fresh Budweiser, the undisputed, undefeated king of beers, this Bud's for you. And special thanks to America Online and AOL members for participating in tonight's telecast. We'd also like to thank our internet partners and the following magazine partners. And finally, we'd like to thank our friends at Sanyo Blimp for their aerial coverage of Memphis this evening. And so, for all of us here at the Pyramid in Memphis, Tennessee, this is James Brown saying so long.
Our executive producers have been Rick Bernstein and Jay Larkin. Tonight's telecast was produced by Dave Harmon and directed by Mark Payton. Associate producers Brian Lockhart, Cameron Penn, and Betsy Aronin. Feature producers Max Siegel, Gil Knight, and Pete Radovich. Assistants to the producers Aptine Motilla and Greg Stern. Production managers Mark Hayden and John McCallie. Technical supervisor Bob Hunter, and the technical director Doug Getz.